pleasant good afternoon, boys and girls, mums and dads. Welcome to another edition of Children's Bible Minutes brought to you by the Anglican Diocese of Belize through the kind courtesy of the Lord Ashcroft COVID-19 Relief Fund. How was your week? Did you have a good week? It's been 7 days since we saw you. That's how long it has been. Now, we hope that you are having a wonderful weekend and that you are looking forward to the new week that is going to begin tomorrow. I think that, you know what? Every time we go into a new week, I'm excited to see what the Lord is going to do. Now, today we are going to talk about the theme of God keeping his promises. That's our theme. God keeps his promises. And the reading we're going to be hearing today is from Genesis, but, before we get into any more details about that, you know we have to start off by giving God some praise. And so we're going to start off with our first song for today, which is called Everybody, Everywhere, and it is done by Jana Aliara. Let's have a listen. Jesus indeed is alive, and everybody everywhere needs to announce that Jesus is alive. We need to proclaim and profess this, boys and girls. So, God is our keeper. That is our theme for today. Last week, we heard the story of Jacob having to run away because he had tricked his brother Esau, and we heard about him being in the field and having a dream about angels going up and coming down on a ladder. And we spoke about looking for the presence of God in the ordinary things. Did you do that this week? Did you try to see God in the regular, ordinary things? We did. And you know what? God is everywhere. And we just love that we could experience him. This week, we're going to again be hearing about Jacob. But this time, Jacob has reached to his uncle's house, Laban. He has reached to his uncle's house and something big is going to happen. We're going to hear all about Jacob's wedding. But there were some rules that he had to follow. And so we're going to learn all about that today in our reading from Genesis 29, 15 to 28. And reading our reading for us today is a good friend of mine by the name of Jordan Peters. And Jordan wanted to be a part of our show. Even though she's not here in Belize, she looks at the show and she enjoys Mookie and Graffy and wanted to be a part of all of this with you as our friends. So let's listen to Jordan Peters doing the reading from Genesis 29, 15 to 28.
Hello. The Old Testament's reading is taken from Genesis chapter 29, verses 15 to 28. Laban said to Jacob, "Just because you are a relative, should you work for me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be?" Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah had weak eyes, but Rachel was graceful and beautiful. Jacob loved Rachel, so he said, "I will work for you 7 years in return for your younger daughter, Rachel." Laban said, "It is better that I give her to you than that I should give her to any other man. Stay with me." So Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed to him but a few days because of the love he had for her. Then Jacob said to Laban, "Give me my wife. My time is completed, and I want to make love to her." So Laban gathered together all people of the palace and made a feast. But in the evening, he took his daughter Leah and brought her to Jacob. And Jacob made love to her. Laban gave his maid Zilpah to his daughter Leah to be her maid. When morning came, there was Leah. And Jacob said to Laban, "What is this? What is this you have done to me? Did I not serve with you for Rachel? Why then have you deceived me?" Laban said, "It is not our custom here to give the younger daughter in marriage before the older one. Finish the daughter's bridal week, then we will give you the younger one also in return for another 7 years of work." And Jacob did so. He finished the week with Leah, and then Laban gave him his daughter Rachel to be his wife.
Thank you so very much, Jordan. We appreciate the fact that you read for us. Now, you know we have to talk about what happened in that story. Plenty things going on in that story. But before we have our discussion on that story, let's listen to our second song. Our second song is called We Love, and it's from Hillsong Young and Free. Let's have a listen.
To your eyes makes my heart come alive. Suddenly brought to life when I met you. Reaching beyond the skies, running deep, stretching wide. Perfect love realized here with you. Now the stuff is for real, you will never let go. Never let go. Oh, it's more than just words, love beyond my control. Out of control.
Heads up!
This is real love. This is real love. And this is real love. This is real love. Hold on, suddenly brought to light when I miss you.
One, two, three, go!
Recap the story real quick. So you remember Jacob had run away from home. He got to a place which was right outside where his cousin, his uncle Laban lived. Now Laban was his mommy's brother. Yes? Now he got there and he met some men who told him that, you know what, they knew his uncle, and he met for the first time the woman he fell in love with, Rachel. Yes? And when he met Rachel, he just instantly fell in love. And you know what? Jacob loved Rachel a whole lot. So when he finally got to his uncle, and you know what? His uncle said, better you stay here with us instead of continue traveling in the wilderness. He decided to stay. And his uncle said, you what? You could work for us, but what should I pay you? Because you can't just work for us for free. And Jacob said, you know what? In exchange for my years of service, I would like to marry Rachel. And Laban thought, you know what? Better for him to marry somebody from our group than somebody else. Work 7 years and I will give you Rachel. And guess what? Jacob worked the 7 years, but Laban tricked Jacob. He tricked Jacob. Now, we have a movie that puts the Bible reading into pictures and words that you could understand what took place. So let's watch this little short video clip that's all about what took place.
Jacob had been traveling for days through the wilderness to reach Haran, where his mother's brother was. Finally, he reached an open space where sheep were grazing. There was a well with a large stone closing its mouth. Shepherds were herding their flock there. Jacob wanted to know where he was, and so he went on to one of the shepherds and spoke to them.
Hello. Where are you from?
We are from Haran. We bring our sheep here to give them water from the well.
Do you know of a man named Laban from Haran?
Yes, we do know him. In fact, that is his daughter coming here right now.
Are you the daughter of Laban?
Yes, I am Rachel, the daughter of Laban. Who are you?
I am Jacob. The son of Rebecca, your father's sister. And I'm so happy to see you.
That's wonderful. You are Rachel's son? My father would be so happy to see you. Let me go and give him this news.
Very well. I will wait here.
Rachel gave water to her sheep and went back to her home to give her father the news.
Father! Father! I have great news for you.
What is it, my dear?
Your sister's son, Jacob, is here in Haran. He has come all the way from Beersheba to see you.
That is wonderful news, Rachel. Let me go and bring him home.
Laban went to meet Jacob and embraced him in joy. He was extremely happy to see his sister's son, as they had never met before. As they walked back to Laban's house, Jacob told Laban about everything that was happening, about Rebecca, Laban's sister, his father Isaac, and how he had made the journey to Haran.
You are indeed my sister's son. Stay with me in my house for as long as you may like.
And so, Jacob stayed at Laban's house and worked with him on his fields and helped with tending the sheep for a month. After a month, Laban spoke to him.
Jacob, my boy, just because you are my relative, it doesn't mean that you do not need to be paid. Ask me what you want in wages, and we will have an arrangement.
Laban had two daughters. The elder was Leah, and the younger one was Rachel. Rachel was very beautiful, and Jacob had fallen in love with her.
I would like to marry your younger daughter, Rachel. And for her, I will work with you for 7 years.
Oh, I'm happy to hear you love my daughter, Jacob. I would gladly marry her to you. So stay here and work with me.
So, Jacob worked for Laban for 7 years in Haran. He loved Rachel very much, and so he didn't find it difficult to work for Laban. At the end of the 7 years, Jacob spoke to Laban.
Laban, I have worked for you for 7 years. Now give me your daughter as my wife, as our agreement.
Very well, Jacob. You have served me well. Let's have a feast in celebration of your marriage.
And so, Laban held a big feast at his home and invited many guests for the marriage of his daughter. However, Laban tricked Jacob by sending his elder daughter Leah with a veil covering her face to be married to Jacob. He also sent a maid by the name of Zilpha as Leah's maid with them. In the morning, Jacob realized he had been tricked, as he did not know it was Leah that was married to him and not Rachel. Jacob was angry. He went to Laban and spoke to him.
Why did you trick me, Laban? I served you for 7 years, and this is how you repay me? You tricked me by sending your elder daughter Leah instead of Rachel. Why did you cheat me? Tell me, Laban, speak to me.
Jacob, my boy, do not be angry. It is not the custom of our land to marry the younger daughter when the elder daughter is unmarried. I will marry Rachel to you after a week, and then you can serve me for another 7 years. This is my request to you.
And so, Jacob married Rachel after a week. Laban also sent another maid servant named Della to help Rachel. Jacob served Laban for another 7 years. He loved Rachel very much, more than Leah. Later on, Leah gave birth to 4 sons, while Rachel did not have any children with Jacob.
What a story brought to us by Animated Kids Bible. You see that? Laban tricked Jacob. He tricked Jacob. He made Jacob work for 7 years to marry Leah. And then what? At the end of the 7 years, he made Jacob marry Leah instead of Rebecca. You see that? He tricked him. Boys and girls, sometimes in this life, we're going to meet people who trick us. We're going to meet people who tell us one thing and do something else. But the truth of the matter is that God keeps his promises. He's the only being that will not lie. He is the only being that if he says it is yes. And if he says it is no all the time. Now, we know that there are people who will tell us yes and will mean yes, and who will say no and mean no. And even though those people are very, very faithful, and those people keep their words, there are instances where they will not always keep their promises. But God, his promises never fail. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 9 tells us, know that the Lord your God is God. He is faithful, and he keeps his covenant of love to the 1000th generation for those who love him and keep his commandments. And that's it. That's what Deuteronomy 7:9 tells us, that God keeps his promises to those who are faithful to him. That those who love and serve God, they are the ones to whom God will keep his promise, because God is faithful. That's it. And in this story, Laban was not faithful, but Jacob was faithful in his love for Rebekah. So he worked 14 years, seven, and then they tricked him to marrying Leah, and then seven more after he had married Rachel. That is some real love. Bigger than that love, however, is the love that God has for us. God's love is bigger even than the love that Jacob had for Rebekah that made him wait for 14 years. God's love is a love that causes him to always keep his promise. You know why? Because God is a faithful God. And you know what, Muki? That reminds me of a song that I heard once from Calvary Kids Worship called Faithful. So let's listen to that song.
Time, and you'll be when it ends. You have no beginning and no end. Your word will endure without change. It is sure. On your promises, we will stand secure.
Promises. He is a powerful God, but he doesn't take advantage of his power. And while humans will fail us, we have to remember that, like it says in Deuteronomy 7:9, God is our God, and he is faithful to keep his covenant of love to the thousandth generation of those who love and keep his commandments. Deuteronomy 7 verse 9. Now, boys and girls, we are quickly running out of time. But you know what? I am glad that we were able to discuss the fact that God keeps his promises. I am glad that we were able to go over the story of Jacob and heard about his two weddings. The fact that Jacob's love was true for Rebekah, and more than that, that God's love is true for us and that he will keep his promise. Now, before we run out of time completely, would you mind if we said a prayer? Excellent. Could you close your eyes and bow your heads? Thank you so much. Let us pray. Good evening, God. God, we just want to thank you for this beautiful Sunday evening. Father, we hope that we could continue to rest in your presence, not only for today, but the entire rest of the week. God, we heard a story today where one man tricked another. God, we know that in this life, sometimes we will meet people who will try to trick us, who will try to convince us that what is not so is so, and what is so is not so. But God, you know what? We ask that you would open our hearts and our minds and our eyes to turn to you, to trust you and to consult with you in all things, because you are faithful and you always keep your promises. God, help us to know that when all else around us fails, you will forever remain the same, that your words and your promises that you have made to us are real. Your promises for prosperity, if we stay true to you, is real. Your love for us that is unfailing will continue to be just that way to the thousandth generation if we keep your commandments. God, we just love you. We thank you for being faithful, and we pray that the love that we have for you could multiply bounds and leaps, that indeed we too might continue to be faithful to you. We thank you, God, for this opportunity to come into your presence. We pray for those who do not know you. We ask that you would use us to draw them closer to you as we ourselves draw close to you. We lift ourselves and our prayers into your presence, God, through the name of your most precious Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, boys and girls, that is all the time we have for today. We're going to close with our final song. This one is called I Will Trust in You from Lifeway Kids. Now, when you come back, when that song is finished, you will not see Graffy Mookie and I. So we just want to thank you for joining us for Children Bible Minutes, a Sunday school program brought to you by the Anglican Diocese of Belize through the kind courtesy of the Lord Ashcroft COVID-19 Relief Fund. We enjoyed our time, and we look forward to seeing you next week, same place, same time. Until then, stay home as much as you can. Remember to stay safe, and do not forget, God keeps his promises and he loves you. Until soon, bye for now.